Welcome back everyone. So today also we are solving one problem on hexagonal lamina. But how it has been resting? It is told it is resting in HP, but with one of its corners on VP. If it is told resting in HP with one of its corner on HP, then you will show the lamina in the horizontal plane with the corner here. But since it is told it is resting in HP with one of the corner in VP, you have to shift the position of the lamina in such a way that it is resting in one of its corner on VP. Then you will get the true shape of the lamina in the front view. Okay, so this is how the position will be when it is resting in HP but with one of the corner in VP. If you write the problem showing in HP, then you will go wrong. Please read the question fully. Even though it is resting in HP, if it is told resting in one of the corner in VP, you have to place the position of the lamina in this way. So when you view from the front, the entire lamina will be visible in our front view, and this will be the true shape. So then when it is viewed from the top, when it is parallel to the VP plane, when you view from the top, the projection of the corner and all the corners will be projected, and you'll be having just in straight line as our top view. So this will be how the position of the first stage will be, the true lamina as the front view. So you project each and every corner, so you'll get a straight line as our top view in the first stage. Okay, and it is a problem on bisector with inclination of HP and VP given, so we need to determine the apparent angle in this case. So let us start up with the problem. Since it is still resting in HP but with one of the corner in VP, we will start up with the front view as explained before. Since the corner should come here, drawing horizontal surface, the side measured is 30 mm, so please show the dimension as 30. Take the interior angle as 120, then you measure 30 mm, cut an arc, measure 30 mm, cut an arc, and again take interior angle of 120 degree, here interior angle of 120 degree, measure 30 mm, cut an arc, measure 30 mm, cut an arc, and then you join. So you will get the required hexagonal lamina. So name it as A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, and F dash. Any order you can take as per your convenience. So this provides us the true shape of the front view. So this is the true shape of it. So then you take the projection from each corner. Okay. So then you will join it. So this is our top view. So in the observer views from the top, A will be visible, so we'll write it as A. So when it views from the top, F will be visible, but B will be hidden because it is on the same line. So we'll write F outside, B in the bracket. And again, when you views from here, E dash will be visible and C dash will be hidden because it is on the same line. So you will write E outside and C inside the bracket. So when he views from here, the corner D will be visible, so I will write it as D. After this, please darken the front view from A to D, sorry, top view. So name it as top view, and this is the first stage what we have completed. So after that, here they have given the inclination both with respect to VP and HP. So it is a direct question. So what is being told? So the, now the surface which is parallel to XY line is inclined at an angle of 30 degree with VP, right? The diagonal passing through that corner which is in VP and is inclined at 45 degree to HP. So this is a diagonal problem related to HP. We will come later. Let us complete the inclination of angle with respect to VP first, because we are starting with the front view and then coming to the top view. So the surface now will be inclined to 30 degree to VP. Show 30 degree line. Okay. So now this surface have to be inclined. So fix one of the end and name this as point A. So measure from A to D is how much, and cut an arc. Name it as D. Then from D to E, how much it is? Measure make a point. From A to F, how much it is we measured, and make a point. Then name this as F of B and E of C. After this, the procedure is same. We take the projection above to our front view. Do the naming properly so and leave spacing properly so that it won't get overlapped. So this is B dash. Okay. So after you extend the projection, you extend the projection from front view also. Got it? So then read the locus. Locus of A is meeting A dash. So this is our A dash. Locus of F is here. F dash is here. It is meeting at this point. So this is F dash. And locus of E is meeting E dash at this point. So this is our E dash. Locus of D is meeting D dash at this point. So this is our D dash. Locus of C is meeting C dash at this point. So this is our C dash. Locus of B is meeting B dash at this point. So this is our B dash. So after naming all the coordinates, join A dash to B dash to C dash to D dash, E dash to D dash, F dash to E dash, A dash to F dash. So this is the second stage. Front view and top view. So this provides a true shape and this is our apparent shape what we are getting. So we completed with the inclination of VP 30 degree where the surface is inclined. So what is being told? So the diagonal passing through the corner. So this is a corner in which it is resting on VP. And the diagonal which is passing through the corner is this corner. A dash to D dash. So now this corner A dash to D dash is in VP and it is inclined at 45 degree to HP. Since it is in VP, you will first fix a point on XY line, but it is inclined to 45 degree to HP. So from that fixed point, so if you fix this point, diagonal point A dash here, so from there, no need of fixing. First we just make a reference point. Take 45 degree to HP. So after taking 45 degree to HP, so now you fix a point A dash, right? So this is the true length and this is the apparent length. This is a bisector problem in which it is told the corner which is in VP is inclined at 45 degree to HP. They haven't told it is appears to be inclined. It is directly inclined to 45 degree to HP bisector. And hence in this we have to determine the apparent angle alpha. So fix this point A dash and measure the true length from the first stage on 45 degree line. And then you cut an arc. So this is our D dash. Name this as D1 dash. Okay. So from D dash you draw a locus. After drawing a locus, now come back to the second stage. So measure the apparent length of the bisector. So now from the same common point A dash, you will cut an arc on the locus of D. So this is locus of D. So this apparent shape will meet somewhere here, apparent length. So name that as D1 dash. So now you have to join A dash to D1 dash. So after joining, this is our apparent length. So extend this back to our XY plane. So this angle will be nothing but our beta. You measure how much it is by determining the by using the protractor. So now this is the bisector what we have shifted to our apparent angle. Sorry, since it is with respect to VP, you have to call it as alpha, not beta. So this is the bisector which we have shifted to our apparent angle. So then remaining part of it has to be constructed. So how do you construct? You need these two corners. Okay, so this is D dash. So from there, you measure this distance, how much it is on the apparent length. So from there, you just draw an perpendicular line. After that, on this locus, you now got the line in which you have these two corners. This corner is already known. So, no need of drawing the construction line at this because this is known already. You need to determine C dash and E dash. That is at a distance, some distance here. So, identify the distance and just draw a line perpendicular to our apparent length of the bisector. Then from D dash, you measure E dash, how much it is. Cut an arc. And again from D dash to C dash, how much it is. You cut an arc. Okay. So, after then you got the point E dash and you got the point C dash. So, now similarly, just draw a perpendicular line from these two. Measure E dash to F dash, how much it is? Cut an arc. Measure C dash to B dash, how much it is? You cut an arc. So, you got C dash and you got D dash. A dash is fixed already. You know this distance. So, join A dash to D dash, A dash to C dash, A dash to B dash, B dash to C dash to D dash, and D dash to E dash. So, now you have shifted the apparent shape of the front view of the hexagonal lamina to our beta angle. Only now we need to determine the apparent shape of the top view in the third stage. So now extend all the projections from each corner without fail and extend the projection from our top view also. Start reading the locus. Locus of A is meeting A dash at this point. So, this is our point A. And locus of F. Where is F here? Okay, this is F. Locus of F is meeting, F dash is meeting F here. So, this is our point F. And locus of B is meeting B dash at this point. So, this is our B. Locus of E is meeting E dash at this point. So, this is our E. Locus of C is meeting C dash at this point. So, this is our C. And locus of D. I draw a slanting line. Draw a vertical line. So, locus of D is meeting D dash at this point. So, this is our point D. So, after getting, kindly join F to E, E to D, C to D, B to C, A to B and A to F. Mine is not exactly parallel line. If you draw exactly parallel line, you will come into picture the real shape of it. So, this will be the third stage. Top view and the front view with respect to the apparent angle determination. So, whenever it is a problem on bisector and if it is told directly inclined to HP related to the position in VP, then you have to determine the apparent angle alpha. Okay. So, this is how you have to solve the problem. Thank you. Next.